For the first time, cameras are allowed in juvenile court for a highly publicized case. And we're finding out why a teenage sexual assault victim believes the Commonwealth's Attorney's Office is bullying her. WLKY's Jessica Oh is here to explain. Jessica?
Vicki, the victim in this case, 17-year-old Savannah Dietrich, believes the Jefferson County Attorney's Office has ties with the two suspects outside the courtroom. So she was in court again today, this time trying to disqualify one of the prosecutors.
Thinking you win some, you lose some.
And for Savannah Dietrich, today's hearing falls under the ladder.
This court finds that the motion to disqualify the Jefferson County Attorney's Office must be overruled, not because
Judge Bissig rejected the 17-year-old's request to drop Paul Rutwalski from the case on grounds that the motion simply didn't have standing. Rutwalski is the chief prosecutor for juvenile court.
I really strongly feel that there was some, he was biased in this case.
Dietrich says Rutwalski not only made insulting comments to her in court, but gave the two suspects unfair plea deals by offering them before their sexual offender assessments came back. Plus, the plea deals allow the suspects to expunge their records when they turn 19.
They kept saying, this is the worst we can do to these kids. It's juvenile court. These are the rules. And we actually knew otherwise.
Savannah's mother spoke to us for the first time today. She believes the reason Rutwalski may be favoring the suspects has to do with the fact that they went to the same local high school as Rutwalski. So we asked County Attorney Mike O'Connell about it.
He's denied that emphatically. And I don't have anything further to say about that. I mean, we could talk about where everybody went to high school and every criminal proceeding or every involvement in Louisville, Kentucky, and you'd probably find the same argument somewhere along the road.
The next step is for Savannah to address the court on a variety of issues like the plea deal, the prosecutor, and how this case has undeniably affected her.
I'm definitely nervous, but to be honest, I've been thinking about that since I reported it. I've been thinking about everything I want to say to the boys.
September 14th is not only the day Dietrich will give her impact statement, it's also the day the two suspects will be sentenced. I'm Jessica Oh, WLKY News.